हेलो एंड वेलकम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ पूर्वांचल स्टूडेंट्स यूनियन एंड यू आर वॉचिंग AMU 11th लाइव फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट एंड ए मोमेंट विच एम्स दैट इट्स वीडियोज विल रीच टू एवरी कॉम्पिटिटर सो दैट ही विल प्रिपेयर फॉर AMU क्लास 11th प्रिपरेशन एज वेल एज JMIE, BHU एटसेट्रा एंड मेनी मोर. एंड टूडे वी विल डिस्कस वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर ऑफ क्लास 10th, लाइफ प्रोसेस साइंस स्पेशली बायोलॉजी क्लास 10th. सो लेट्स बिगिन. वन मोर अनाउंसमेंट, इफ यू वांट टू जॉइन अस ऑन टेलीग्राम देन क्लिक द लिंक इन डिस्क्रिप्शन और टाइप दिस लिंक इन योर ब्राउजर एंड जॉइन अस, आस्क योर क्वेरीज फॉर एटसेट्रा. Now we'll start our lecture with a beautiful motivation line. Let's read it. Struggler will be strong. Those who will struggle will be strong. If you're facing difficulty in any area, in any subject, if you will struggle in that subject, then you will be strong. So this line forces us to struggle. So with this beautiful and amazing line, let's start our today's lecture. Basically, we will talk about life process. What are life processes? The processes which together perform the maintenance job of life are called life processes. Life processes include ingestion, digestion, absorption, assimilation, etc. And the very important is that viruses do not show molecular movement until they infect some cell. In fact, viruses are a link between living and non-living. If you are with copy and pen, then note it down, it's very important. Life on earth depends on carbon based molecules. Yes, because all the food we eat, mostly these are made up of carbon and carbon compounds. So these are very important for us as well as for maintaining life. And most of food sources are carbon based. Earlier we have discussed. Now we will discuss a very important line of NCERT, which is very important again. Oxidizing reducing reactions are most common chemical means to break down molecules. In fact, oxidation and reduction reactions undergo and break down our complex sugar or complex food we eat and convert it into simpler one. Now a very important is that in multicellular organisms, simple diffusion is insufficient to meet the oxygen requirements of multicellular organisms. Therefore, in multicellular organisms, a respiratory system is necessary. And it is very interesting fact that in human beings, if there were no circulatory system, then oxygen from lungs will reach up to toes, and it is very slow process and it will take up to 3 years. Now we will talk about autotrophs in brief. Important points: green plants, some bacteria, and euglena are autotrophs. This is very important. Euglena is only animal which is autotroph. This is the fact, and note it down. Now we'll talk about action of enzymes. Enzymes are basically a biocatalyst and increase the rate of reaction. By the help of enzymes, our food breaks down easily and it takes very less time. Now we'll talk about heterotrophs. What are basically heterotrophs? Heterotrophs are those who depend on other organisms for their food. They depend directly and indirectly on autotrophs. In fact, autotrophs are called producers and heterotrophs are called consumers. Now we'll talk about heterotrophs. Heterotrophs include animals and fungi. Fungi are non-green and therefore are heterotrophs. Now we will discuss important NCERT lines which are important for AMU examinations. Carbon and energy requirements of autotrophs are fulfilled by photosynthesis. It is very simple, you know. Now one more thing is that unused carbohydrates are stored immediately in plants in the form of starch. The unused product carbohydrate after formation in the plants are used in the form of starch. This is what you have to learn it. Now we'll talk about glycogen. In human beings, this is for human beings, some of our energy derived from food we eat is stored in our body in form of glycogen. Now we'll discuss the process of photosynthesis in a little bit detail. Photosynthesis is a process in which plants produce their food using sunlight. Absorption light is by chlorophyll, conversion of light chemical, splitting water molecule into hydrogen oxygen, reduction of carbon dioxide into carbohydrates. Desert plant take up CO2 at night and prepare an intermediate which is acted upon by the energy absorbed by chlorophyll during day. This is very important NCERT line, note it down. Now we'll talk about the function of stomata. What are stomata are actually? Stomata are tiny pores present on surface of leaf. In fact, stomata allows and exits air in plants found in leaves. Exchange of gases occur across surface of stem, roots, leaves as well, not only leaves, very important. Opening and closing of stomata is a function of guard cells. Stomata open and close due to guard cells. It's function of guard cell, learn it. Guard cells swell when water flows into them and stomata opens. Stomata closes when guard cells shrink. Now we'll talk about a very important fact. Potassium hydroxide, KOH. Potassium hydroxide absorbs CO2. It is a perfect absorbent of carbon dioxide. Now we'll talk about some important compounds essential for important elements essential for plant, which are macronutrients. Nitrogen, phosphorus, iron, magnesium. Nitrogen is used in synthesis of proteins and other compounds. Nitrogen is taken in form of organic nitrates and nitrites. This is what very important, learn it, note it down. So finally, friends, this was our brief lecture. In the next lecture, we will talk about further things. So please like, share and subscribe to our channel. You are watching MU11th Live. If you are if you want the PDF of lecture, then PDF of lecture is in description, so click in description and download the PDFs. Also join us on Telegram via link in description. Further, one more thing, please like, share and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching this video, thanks a lot, care a lot, do subscribe, etc.